Hello, welcome back to Pleasantview. Today we will be joining the hospital in Pleasantview. And that building is located over here. And the family that takes care of the hospital is the Pleasant family. And more specifically, it is Jennifer Pleasant who lives over here. She is living in one of the base camp houses next to her brother. So I'm going to join Jennifer's household and meet you up there. It's morning in the Pleasant household, and like I have done for the other houses, I will give you a quick tour of this house as well. So this is one of the base game houses that I have renovated once again. We have a garage on the side, and then we have an entrance right here. It leads into the kitchen. And then we have a dining room. It's not very decorated yet. A small downstairs bathroom. And a living room. Then upstairs, we have the landing and a small office for Jennifer with her piano. That is her hobby, music and dance. We have the, well, master bathroom, I suppose, and the master bedroom. Jennifer is currently asleep. And then we have a little garden as well. So Jennifer is not going to start work until 10 a.m. So she needs to leave for work at 9. So we have a little bit of a morning to get to know her. So let's just start off with her personality. She is a Gemini. So she is pretty outgoing. And pretty serious as well. She's a little bit more fit than she is overweight. Her lifetime goal is to become chief of staff. And like I told you, her hobby is music and dance. Her secondary ambition is the popularity. And yeah. Jennifer was, of course, Jennifer Burb at the start of the game. And like most of you probably know, she was married to John Burb previously. I will show you her family tree. So she is the sister of Daniel Pleasant. And she has one daughter, Lucy Bertino, who has one child so far, Phoebe Bertino. And Jennifer was, like I told you, married to John when they arrived here. They had had Lucy very young while Jennifer was still in school. And once she had graduated from the university, John and Jennifer decided to move to Pleasantview because John got employed at the local high school as a teacher. And Jennifer also got a job as a nurse at the hospital. So I'm going to tell you more from John's point of view when I move over to the Burb household. But as for Jennifer, she was very pleased to get close to her family, her brother. And she wanted to succeed in her career before she started to develop her family more. John was very eager to have more children and build up a bigger foundation in Pleasantview. But Jennifer really wanted to succeed and focus on her career before anything. So it started with getting promoted from nurse to intern, and then from intern to resident. And her work hours shifted a lot, and she had a hard time keeping up with her family. At the same time, she also wanted to get to know the people in Pleasantview and get some friends. But she didn't feel like she had time to do everything. So she found herself working until very late in the evenings, and whenever John wanted to spend time together, she was busy with her own things, trying to develop her skills in order to get those promotions that she wanted. And in the end, it just became too much for John, Jennifer thinks, because he snapped from her point of view, and they had a big fight. Jennifer sort of told John that she wasn't going to want to have any more children, because they already had Lucy and Jennifer had so much to do at the hospital, and she still wanted to get more promotions and just focus on that. And that wasn't acceptable to John, because they had agreed before they even moved to Pleasantview that they were going to have a bigger family, and that was something that he really, really wanted. And that was a big no-no for him. He also told her that she hadn't been there for Lucy. Lucy was basically only being raised by John at that point, because Jennifer was at work while she was home from school, and when she was at school, Jennifer was home just working on her own things. So because Jennifer didn't spend any time with Lucy and didn't seem to care about her development, that was something that John really couldn't accept either. And that is something that Jennifer felt bad about, but that she didn't feel that she could change. So, well, in the end, they decided to break off their marriage. And Jennifer had to move in with her brother for a while. And after that, she moved into an apartment while she got things together. While her personal life was very shaky, she finally got that promotion that she had strived for as a general practitioner. And that was when she also took over the ownership of the hospital. So she has huge responsibilities right now, and she hasn't really wanted to start a new family. She has just wanted to focus on her career. She has had a fling or a affair with one of the employees. His name is Grayson Bendett, and he is married to Marissa Bendett. But that didn't work out in the end. Grayson decided that he wanted to remain faithful to his wife. So Jennifer really has no one in her life that she can be romantic with. And that is something that is pretty sad to her. She really would like to have someone to share her life with. She is a bit lonely now that she has reached the top of the medical career in Pleasantview. She really finds herself alone at the top. And that has turned out to be something that she would like to change if she can, but she finds it very hard to do so. She's also feeling really, really bad about her treatment of Lucy as a child and a teenager. They didn't, after Jennifer moved out, they didn't interact at all. And Jennifer actually had such a bad conscience about that she didn't dare reach out to Lucy to speak with her over the phone or anything like that. So they didn't actually even meet again until Jennifer was invited to Lucy's wedding. And that was when they sort of rekindled a tentative relationship, but it's not back to normal. You can see that they have a pretty high relationship, even though that they are only friends, because they have been speaking to each other lately and rekindle that, but they're not really that close. She's a lot closer to Angela Pleasant than she is to her own daughter. And that is sort of the backstory of Jennifer and why she ended up where she is currently. So she's going to wake up from her dreams and get ready for her work day. it's hailing outside, so she's checking the weather and isn't very happy about it. She's going to have a shower. And then she's going to have some breakfast as well before work. Yeah, so I think that she will have some yogurt with fresh fruit. And this is sort of Jennifer's calm morning routine before going off to the hospital. Things get pretty hectic over there, as it normally is with hospitals. You never know what you arrive to when you get to work. It's always going to be some situation or other that you have to resolve. So she really enjoys these calm mornings where she can take her time and have her shower and breakfast and read a newspaper before she leaves. But as you can see, she is doing this all by herself. She has no one to share her dinners with. So she's going to clean up after breakfast, and she only has 1 hour left to get to work. She's going to grab the newspaper and read it for a little bit before she leaves. As you can see, she isn't taking it into the kitchen or the living room. She's just going to sit down a bit quickly. She's ready to leave. She doesn't take her time to sit down. She's really a workaholic at heart. Yeah, so she has had some time to pick up on the news, and she's going to get to work. And this is going to work the same as it has for the schools. I'm going to send her off to her community lot, and that is going to simulate her going to work. So I will meet you back at the hospital. Jennifer has arrived at the hospital, and I'm going to give you a quick tour. This is the parking lot with an ambulance. And this is the hospital building. So going down to the ground floor, we have the entrance over here with some elevators, and we have the men's bathroom and the women's bathroom. We have a cafeteria where the guests, patients, and the hospital workers as well can have their lunch or a snack. We have a waiting room with a reception desk. And we have a laboratory, as well as a lecture hall. On the first floor, we have a corridor. And we have a bedroom or a ward, I suppose this is called, with a small bathroom. We have a meeting room for the staff. And we have one of the offices or the examination rooms, perhaps. And we have another one in here. On the second floor, we have the physiotherapy room. And we have Jennifer's office. So that's what the hospital looks like. I have spawned the hospital workers who will be joining us today. We have Joe Brunig, who you've already met. We have his daughter, Marsha Brunig. We have Angela Pleasant. And we have Don Lothario. And we also have, let's take down the wall so you can see him. We have Johnson Hamilton, who is a randomly generated sim, but I have involved him in my rotations. And he is actually going to work in the lab because he's employed in the science career rather than the medical one. So he's going to be in charge of creating the medicine today. I'm going to show you my spreadsheet for the medical career. It is a bit intense. So we have the general practitioners, and that is Joe Brunig and Jennifer Pleasant. We have the residents who work the evening shift, so they will not be joining us today, but they are Grayson Bendette and Edith Day. We have the interns, who are Don Lothario and Kaylin Cox. Kaylin will not be joining us today because she has fallen ill. We have the nurses, who are Angela Pleasant and Marsha Brunig. And we also have the project leaders, or the laboratory personnel. And that is today going to be only Johnson Hamilton, because Brandy Lillard has also fallen ill. So if we take a look at my illness tab, I have a work in progress system for how I calculate this. I randomize which sims will get ill for each weekday. So for week 4, Monday, we have Nina Caliente, Ivy Cooper, and Kaylin Cox, who will have a cold. Nina Caliente has already randomly gotten a cold while I played her the previous day, so she's already set, but I will have to infect the other sims. Ophelia Hamilton is going to get the flu, as will Tosha Lillard and Brandy Lillard. And then we have Benjamin Day and Randy Lillard, who will get pneumonia. So if we take a look at the hospital tab, this is the set tasks for today. We have the people with pneumonia, and the treatment is going to be hospitalization. So that was Benjamin Day and Randy Lillard. And it is going to be Jennifer who is going to take care of them today. And they will owe a fee of 800 simoleons for that treatment. We have the people with flu, and their treatment is going to be prescription of medicine. So that was Tosha Lillard, Ophelia Hamilton, and Brandy Lillard. And Joe Brunig is the sim who will take care of them. And that fee is going to be 500 simoleons for the medicine. Then we also have a checkup because of old age. And that is going to be Jan Tellerman today, who needs a checkup. And it is going to be Don Lothario who takes care of her. The fee is going to be 200 simoleons for that. And we also have a physiotherapy treatment for back pain. And that is going to be Brandy Burb. Like we saw when we played the elementary school, she left at 2. So she actually went to Don Lothario to get some treatment for her back pain. And that's going to cost her 300 simoleons. Normally, I also bring in the pregnant sims for a checkup, but there was no pregnant sims this time, so we don't have one this round. I also have not used the visitor controller to block any visitors on this lot, so we might get some random sims who join us and want some treatment as well. We will have to see who shows up. So I'm going to start off with the two Sims who will be hospitalized, and that was Benjamin Day as the first Sim. There we go. And that is, of course, Benjamin Long, who has married Edith Day and changed his last name. And then we also had Randy Lillard. There we go, and that is Randy London, who has some family connections that has turned him into a Lillard. So I'm going to make them selectable. And then I'm going to use the Gussy Up mod in order to change their clothes so that they can have the hospital gown on while they are hospitalized. Yeah, since I already have the hospital gown on this lot, I only have to plan outfit actually. So I'm going to change him into that outfit. There we go. So Benjamin and Randy are wearing their gowns, so I'm going to have them relax on the beds for now. And then I'm going to summon the Sims that I'm going to have to infect. And I'm going to use this cheat object in order to give them the illnesses. And that is one of the things you can spawn. It is the Make Me Sick tester. And it spawns like that. So we had Ivy Cooper. So I'm going to make her selectable, and I'm going to infect her with a cold. There we go, Ivy is sick with a cold. Then I can just clear off Ivy. And I'm going to continue with the other Sims that I have to infect. Okay, so everything is set. All the Sims that were going to be infected have been infected. I have also infected Randy Lillard and Benjamin Day with pneumonia. So Jennifer is going to enter work, and she's going to start with changing into her work outfit. That's going to be medicine level 6. There we go. And then she's going to have a meeting with her staff the first thing in the morning. So she's going to sit down. I have also sent the Sims to doing some tasks. I have sent the sick Sims with the flu into the waiting room, so that they can sit here and wait for the doctor to see them. I have also sent Marcia to the reception to work on some logic skills and looking after the patients. And I have asked Angela to go into the laboratory and practicing on some of these dummies. I don't know if she is on her way. She's not. Please do that. And then we have Joe, we have Don, and we have Johnson waiting for Jennifer to arrive at the meeting room. So they are going to discuss how things look after the night, what patients they have, and if they have any news. And sort of divide the tasks for what they need to do today. And all the workers will give a short catch-up for Jennifer. How their work looks for today. There we go. So, we have Benjamin is coughing his lungs up, so he needs to relax again. Johnson is going to go down into the laboratory to make medicine. See that Angela has started practicing on the dummies in there. Looks like we have some randomized people as well. Alexander Goff is here. And we also have Alba Landgrab so far as well. So we are going to start things off. Jennifer is going to take this room. And I am going to have Joe take this room. And Don is going to go up to his office and work for a little bit before his first patient arrives. So now that Jennifer has entered her office, we are going to start with Randy. Just to make sure that the illness took, I'm going to do it again. Because there was some issues that I had to resummon him. Oh, looks like he has a symptom, so yeah, he is sick, definitely. Good. Looks like Benjamin is resting well, reading some. So I'm going to have Randy enter Jennifer's office and... oh no, he's running. They're going to greet each other. Looks like Brandy is ready for her examination, let's say. So she's going to sit down. She knows Joe well. I think that they actually have to greet each other before they can interact. Did you greet? Yeah, good. So Randy is going to sit down in the examination chair and Jennifer is going to talk with him. Yo is going to greet Brandy. And Brandy is going to sit down. And Joe is going to talk with her as well. Looks like Don is done with his work. Let's see who he was supposed to meet. It was Jan Tellerman for a checkup. So I'm going to teleport Jan Tellerman. She is. And I'm going to give her a key because the sims are very attracted to this exercise machine. I have to keep this door firmly locked. So Jan Tellerman can enter for now. Okay, so the patients are being examined. Looks like Randy's examination is done, so Jennifer is going to sit down again and he is going to go back to rest. So she is going to get a prescription for some medication. So I'm going to take that out of Jennifer's inventory. And I'm going to add that into her inventory. So that was Joe giving that to her. So now that her examination is done, Joe will take another seat and I'm going to make Brandy unselectable. So she is done. Just going to keep Don occupied while he waits for his patient. Jan is entering the room, so he's going to greet her. Looks like Johnson is done with the first medicine, so he's going to put it into the inventory. And that is going to give it to Jennifer's inventory. That is a mod that I used that makes that possible. He's going to make more medicine. Looks like Brandy said goodbye to Jennifer. Let her know that she's going to head home now, that she got some medication, and Jennifer told her to please take care of her health and get back to work once she's healthy again. So Jennifer is going to sit down again, and I'm going to have Benjamin sit down. Looks like they are going to run if I ask them to go somewhere, so going to do it that way instead. So let's see where we have the other patients. Have they left the waiting room? Of course they have. Okay, so I think that I am going to lock this door for now because it seems like they are going to try to use that bathroom. So, Ophelia is going to sit down. And I'm going to have Tosha finish up in here. And then sit in this waiting room instead. Looks like Benjamin is feeling a bit dizzy from the pneumonia. There we go. Now I am going to lock this door for now, and I can open it when I want to have one of the patients use it, but the visitors won't use it anyway then. Okay, so looks like Joe has started to interact with Ophelia, so he's going to stand up and speak with her. Jennifer is also going to speak with Benjamin. Don is going out here to talk to Jan. I left them too long, it seems, but I'm going to have him sell a massage to Jan. So that is going to be taken care of. I don't know where Tosha is running to, but I want you to sit there. I think it's because she doesn't have any entertainment right there. Looks like Joe is done with Ophelia. I'm going to have him sit down again. And I'm going to give Ophelia a vial as well of medicine. She's going to take that. And then I'm going to make her unselectable. And I'm going to finish off with Tosha. Okay, so Jennifer has spoken with Benjamin. So he's going to get back to his bed and relax. Jennifer is going to work. Trying to figure out what is wrong with them and what treatment they need. It looks like Marcia is done with her article in here. We don't really have any patients right now, so I'm going to ask her to clean that. I think that was filthy, and then use it. And then she can start off with her lunch. Angela is going to continue a bit more. Looks like Johnson is done with some more medicine, so he's going to put it into the inventory. And then I'm going to have him... this needs to be moved back a bit. I'm going to have him use the bathroom as well. And have lunch. Let's see who ends up having the time to do it first. Okay, so she's working. Looks like Joe has started to speak with Tosha, so I'm going to have him stand up again. And Don is waiting for Jan, who is using the elevator. Okay, good. So she's going to get her treatment. Okay, so it cost her 100 simoleons. I have to take that into account for her checkup. The checkup was supposed to be 200, so I'm going to lower that in my notes to 100 so that she doesn't pay too much. Yeah, so she's going to get a nice treatment in there. Randy is not feeling well. I'm going to give a key to Randy, and I'm also going to give a key to Benjamin so that they can use these bathrooms. Okay, he's having another near faint. Okay, good. So it looks like Joe might be done as well with Tosha. So I'm going to give her some medicine as well. Looks like she got a very potent one. The darker in blue, the better the quality, if I remember correctly. So she's going to take that into her inventory, and I'm making her unselectable. So Joe is going to use the bathroom, and I'm going to send him to lunch too. Looks like Johnson needs to resume cooking and use the TV dinner. Yeah, I think that Angela can head off to lunch as well. So she's finishing up with her life-saving practicing. Let's see what she finds. Oh, she didn't find anything. Or does she? Yeah, okay, that looks like it might or not belong in there. It was some sort of organ at least, but the color wasn't very good. Okay, so looks like I can have Angela get some lunch now as well. Don can take his lunch too. I'm going to send him to the bathroom. And then he's going to have some TV dinner. Jennifer is going to finish up with her work. How are the patients doing in here? Randy has disappeared. Okay, he's watching TV in here. That's not very good. I want you to actually go back in here so that Jennifer can give you some medicine. There we go. So she's going to stop that. And she's going to give that vial to Randy. He's going to actually take it. There we go. He took the medicine. So I'm going to send him back in here to relax some more and see if the illness disappears. Jennifer will have her lunch now too as well. I'm going to just do this. Looks like it wasn't cleaned like it should have been. Okay, so some of the personnel have looks like they are interacting with some of the patients. I think I'm going to clear off Ophelia because she is ill and shouldn't still be here. There we go. So, Johnson, you can go back to work, make more medicine. And Marcia, you can ask Alexander to move out of your spot at the reception desk. Or, well, I think that I'm going to switch it up a bit so that Angela can take this position now and Marcia can practice on this instead. Jennifer is coming down. Okay, so Tosha is still here as well. I think I'm going to clear her off, so that we don't have a lot of sick sims at the hospital. Angela is going to clean up a little bit because her colleagues weren't very well good at that. So where do we have Benjamin? I want you to go back to relaxing. And Jan is apparently up here being the masseuse. I don't want her to do that, but I will clear her off as well because she is done with her treatment. And sit down. He is going to wait for his next patient, which is going to be Brandy Burb. And Jennifer is finally going to have her lunch. Angela is not appreciating her work of cleaning up the place. This is, was not what she signed up for when she joined the medical career. But it's what needs to be done, so she has to do it. Then she's going to take her position at the reception desk. Let's see, Don has arrived in his office. I'm going to summon Brandy for him. So I'm going to switch up the keys so that Brandy can enter the room. And I'm going to have her walk up here. There she comes. Don is going to greet her. And then he's going to sell her some massage. Great. Okay. Johnson has finished more medicine, so he's going to put it in the inventory, and then I'm going to have him work a little bit as well on other things. Angela has taken her position at the reception. Looks like Jennifer is greeting some of the patients, and it looks like Lucy has come as well, her daughter, and they are greeting each other pretty warmly. They're happy to see each other. So I think that Lucy is here to have an examination to see if she has become pregnant. She has had some symptoms and she just wants to have a quick check how that looks. So she's going to sit down and I'm going to have Joe examine her. Jennifer is going to meet with Benjamin now. It is time for him to have some medicine as well. So Randy doesn't seem to have been cured yet. Still very tired. So I'm going to give him another vial of medicine and then I'm going to send him home to sleep a bit and hopefully that will cure him. So he's going to take that and then I'm going to clear him off. So let's see if we can cure Benjamin. Going to talk a bit with him. And Joe is going to stop that and examine Lucy. Okay, so Benjamin can go ahead and drink some of that medicine and see if we can cure you. Yeah. I'm going to do the same thing for him. I'm going to give him one more vial that he can bring home. And then I'm going to clear him off. So, Brandy is done with her therapy as well. I'm going to have her exit Don's office. I'm going to remove her key. And Don is going to work a bit more. Okay, so Lucy has had her examination. Going to make her unselectable again. And Joe is going to go back to his office to work a bit more. Yeah, and then I'm going to make Brandy unselectable as well. So just during the final hours until 6 p.m. I'm just going to keep this up. I'm actually going to leave a bit earlier because otherwise I think that they might age. I'm not sure if they will do that on the community lot, but Marsha is going to take a break from that and do some cleaning up in here. Of course, the guests are leaving things all over the place. Okay, Jennifer is doing her own thing, but I think that she would go back to her office and work a little bit more for the final hours. Angela and Marsha actually should have left already, so I'm going to have them leave work now. going to clear them both off. Because their workday starts at 7 and finishes at 2 p.m. Just going to check that I didn't miss anybody that I should have worked with today. No, we managed to get to every patient. So they are just going to finish up work. And I'm going to send Jennifer back home around 5. So I'm going to have him make more medicine before he leaves. Don is also working on his things. Looks like Joe has finished. He can go down here for a bit and just speak a bit. Practice his speech. So he's going to have a little chat with the skeleton. Very good. And then I'm going to have Johnson head home. Okay, so I'm going to close up shop and send Jennifer back home. So clear off all non-residents. And I'm going to have Jennifer drive home. And we will meet her back at her house. Jennifer is returning home to her house. And I'm going to stop here for Jennifer. I'm going to send her to work. And she will get back home once her work is done. And we will return later to this household to finish up her day. I hope you enjoyed this episode and see you next time. Take care. Bye.